The program Calcusyn or Compusyn is considered to be one of the simplest software programs for quantifying synergism or antagonism. It is based on the principle of low additivity and median drug effect analysis derived from mass action enzyme kinetic models, previously established for enzyme-substrate interactions, and then extended to multiple drug combinations. It assumes that two or more drugs alone, as well as the combination, will result in sigmoid concentration effect curves. In this video, we will demonstrate how to use Calcusyn software to analyze combination studies with a fixed constant ratio or a nonconstant ratio, with simultaneous drug exposure or sequential drug exposure schedules. According to the median effect analysis, the combination index, or CI, quantitatively evaluates the nature of drug interaction and is defined by the equation shown here. The denominators, DX1 and DX2, are drug doses required to achieve a given effect level as single agent. The numerators D1 and D2 are doses of each drug in a given mixture which give the same effect level. For mutually exclusive drugs that have the same or similar modes of action, alpha will be set as 0. For mutually non-exclusive drugs that have totally independent modes of action, alpha is equals to 1. For three drug combinations, a third term D3 over DX3 can be added to equation. Assumes that DX1 and DX2 are the IC50 values of drug A and drug B alone. And D1 and D2 are the doses of drug A and drug B that also produce 50% inhibition when given together. The effect of drug combinations is then plotted as graph where the X and Y axis are the concentrations of drug A and drug B. A line connecting the concentrations that produce the same effect on the target protein for both drug A and drug B can be drawn and represents the additive effects when both drugs are combined. If drug A has an IC50 of 500 arbitrary units and the IC50 of drug B is 100 arbitrary units, from the additivity line, the combination of 250 arbitrary units of drug A with 50 arbitrary units of drug B should also give 50% inhibition. If the combination of drug A and drug B produce an additive effect, the combination index will equal to 1. If the 50% inhibition are achieved at lower concentrations of the two drugs, the drugs would show synergism. The IC50 curve would not be a straight line, but an upward concave, and the CI will be less than 1. Conversely, if the observed inhibition by the combination was less than 50%, drug A and B would interact in an antagonistic way. The resulting isobol would be a downward concave. The CI will be more than 1. If a plot of CI as a function of effect level FA is plotted, the CI values will reflect the mode of drug interactions at any effect level and at which drug concentration is needed to achieve this effect. Both FACI plot and isobologram yield identical conclusion of synergism or antagonism. The FACI plot is effect-oriented, whereas isobologram is dose-oriented. Both graphics can be considered two sides of the same coin. However, FACI plot is visually more convenient to use than isobologram since data point overcrowding in isobologram at various effect levels can be avoided. Based on the combination index equation, if two drugs show synergy, one will expect that a lower dose of each is needed to achieve the same effect. This lower concentration D1 and D2 can be related to the median, such as IC50, to give the dose reduction index, or DRI. DRI is a measure of how many folds the dose of a combined drug may be reduced at a given effect level as compared to the dose of the drug alone. DRI is an important parameter in clinical practice because a favorable value may lead to reduced systemic toxicity toward healthy tissues while maintaining therapeutic efficacy. Now that we have reviewed the principle behind the calculations and models of Calcusyn, let's look into data analysis. To ensure that the data analysis is robust, we first need to ensure that the experiment to investigate the drug combination is properly designed. First, prerequisite dose effect curves. Each drug alone should have a dose effect relationship. Both potency and shape parameters are essential for determining synergism or antagonism. If one of the two drugs has no effect by itself, then synergism or antagonism cannot be determined. Instead, potentiation or suppression should be determined. Second, prerequisite number of data points. At least three or more data points for each single drug are required for the determination of potency and shape, and thus for the determination of CI values. For combinations, in contrast, any number of data points can be used for the CI calculations. And third, accuracy of measurement and conformity to the mass action law. The linear correlation coefficient, or R, of the median effect plot should be reasonably good. For enzyme or receptor systems, the linear correlation coefficient of more than 0.96 is recommended. For tissue culture systems, the linear correlation coefficient should be more than 0.90. And for animal experiments, the linear correlation coefficient of more than 0.85 is considered good. The most efficient way for experimental design is to choose the combination drugs at their equipotent ratio, such as at the ratio of their IC50. After the ratio is set, it is usual to make a mixture of the two drugs at 4 or 8 fold of their IC50 and serially dilute the mixture to obtain a good dosage range and dose density. A schematic presentation for constant ratio design of two drug combination is given here. This design can be expanded to a large dose range or larger density. The advantage of the constant ratio design is that it allows each mixture to be treated as a drug to obtain the DM and M parameters. It also allows the automated construction of FACI table, FACI plot, and classic or conservative isobolograms. As indicated by the multiple drug effect equation, each term of the equation is the dividing ratio. Therefore, the unit for each term cancels out and becomes a dimensionless quantity. Therefore, two drugs with different units can be combined and the results analyzed as usual. Sometimes, researchers design their drug combinations with random or arbitrary ratios, or vary the concentrations of one drug while keeping the second drug concentration fixed. As long as the M and DM parameters for each single drug are available, the CI values for each data point of the non-constant ratio design can still be calculated. However, this design will not provide FACI plot simulation, although the combination data points can be placed on the FACI plot. Furthermore, the classic isobologram or the conservative isobologram cannot be constructed for the non-constant ratio design. However, the DX normalized isobologram can be constructed automatically. This normalized isobologram provides information of synergism or antagonism of each combination data point, but will not provide the information of the dose and FA in the normalized isobologram. For three drug combinations, it is suggested that the ratio for drug 1, 2, and 3 be first selected so that the single drug data and their parameters can be shared and reused. Two drug combinations, if used, should be correspond to three drug ratios so that the effective drug ratio for D1 to D2, D2 to D3, and D1 to D3 can be calculated. In this case, the component combinations can also be determined for their synergism or antagonism. For example, D1 plus D2 can be synergism, D2 plus D3 can be antagonism, and etc. Whether D1 plus D2 plus D3 is synergism or antagonism can then be calculated directly with or without component dissections. For the combination of more than three drugs, the same principles and rules apply. To start using Calcusyn, we will create a new experiment. Go to File New command to create a new experiment in Calcusyn. The left-hand pane will be populated with the experiment basics. Double-click on Experimental Details to enter the experiment properties. Double-click on Raw Data to open the raw data grid to enter drug data. You can save an experiment using the File Save option, or open an existing experiment with the File Open command. On the left-hand side of the program screen is the contents pane that shows the contents of your experiment. Double-click on items in the pane to open them. There are two methods to enter a drug. Using the Add Drug Wizard or Add Drug Manually. To add a drug using the Add Drug Wizard entry. Double-click the raw data item in the contents pane to open the raw data grid and enter the data into the grid. Select Drugs, Add Drug Wizard, or click the Toolbar button. This will open the first page of the wizard. Enter the name of the drug, any comments, and the drug units in the boxes provided and select a no combination drug. Then click the next button to proceed to the next page of the wizard. Now specify the drug data by clicking the select button. Highlight the dose data in the grid shown and click the select menu option. Repeat for the effect data. Click the finish button and the drug will be added to the experiment and shown in the contents pane. To add drug manually, select drugs then add drug manually, or click the toolbar button. This will open the manual entry dialog. Enter the drug details, name, comments, and unit. Enter the first data point by selecting New. Enter the dose in effect. Clicking on OK will complete the entry. Enter the remaining points by pressing Enter or clicking on New to bring up the New Points dialog. As the points are entered, they will be added to the graph, and once three or more points have been added, the DM, M, and R values will be displayed. Select a data point and select Edit to modify any values. Click OK and the drug will be added to the experiment and shown in the contents pane. As with entering a single drug, there are two methods to enter a combination drug, using the Add Drug Wizard or Add Drug Manually. To add a combination drug using the Add Drug Wizard entry, double-click the raw data item in the contents pane to open the raw data grid and enter the data into the grid as shown. Enter the two or more drugs which form the combination or mixture using the approach for entering single drugs. Select drugs, Add Drug Wizard, or click the toolbar button. This will open the first page of the wizard. Enter the name of the drug, any comments, and the drug units in the boxes provided and select a combination drug. Then click the next button to proceed to the next page of the wizard. Select the drugs which form the combination from the list. State that the drugs are in constant ratio to each other and enter the ratio of the two drugs to each other. Then click the next button. Select the dose and effect data for the mixture and then click Finish. The drug will then be added to the experiment and shown in the contents pane. Any number of combinations can be created in this way. To enter a non-constant ratio combination drug, follow the procedure for entering a combination drug. In both the wizard and manual entry, untick the constant ratio box. You will then be required to enter the dose data for all drugs in your combination. You can only enter non-constant ratio combinations containing up to 6 drugs using the wizard. For combinations containing more than 6 drugs, you can create the individual drugs using the wizard, but you will need to create the combination using manual entry. To view the reports, double-click the report in the contents tree that you want to open. The report window will be displayed. This is a standard text window with most of the controls available in Notepad. Text can be copied from the window and pasted into a spreadsheet or word processor for further formatting or processing. The text can be printed using the file, print command and exported to file using the right-click menu. Report contents can include any of the following. Experiment details. The title, notes, date of experiment, investigator, and file name are always displayed at the top of a report. The drug summary and data points are displayed for each component drug and for the combination drug. Drug summary. The drug name and comment, DM, M, and R are displayed with estimated uncertainties. Unless otherwise indicated, when a value is quoted as X plus or minus Y, X is the calculated value and Y is the standard deviation. Data points entered. The data points are displayed in increasing dose order as entered. Dose effect table. The estimated dose required to produce the given effect is displayed for a range of effect values. This range can be set in the reporting options dialog. The uncertainties in dose are estimated using an algorithm. The limits give the range in which it is 95% certain that the value will fall. Note, for combination drugs, the dose displayed is the dose of first component only. CI for experimental values. The combination index value for each entered data point is displayed here. CI simulations. The combination index estimated for each effect value is given in this table. The range of effect values can be set in the reporting options dialog. Monte Carlo simulations. If the Monte Carlo option is selected in the reporting options dialog, then the mean and standard deviation values of CI calculated using the Monte Carlo algorithm are displayed as for the CI simulations above. DRI calculations. If the display DRI values option is set in the reporting options dialog, then the dose reduction index values will be calculated for a range of effect values. And finally, summary table. The summary table gives a one-line summary of the drug parameters for each component and for the combination drug. To view the graphs, double-click the graph in the contents tree that you want to open. The graph window shows a selection of graphs derived from the data. For single drugs, this will be the median plot and the dose effect plot. Combination drugs will also show the CI plot. Graphs can be printed using the file, print option from the menu. Graphs can be copied to the clipboard and exported to file from the right-click menu. There are three export options in Calcusyn: raw data, reports, and graphs. Open the relevant window, either the raw data grid, a report window, or a graph window, then select file, then export. Raw data. You can export raw data as tab-separated text or .txt or as an Excel 97.xls file. You will be presented with a standard file save dialog box. Enter the name of the file to export to and click save. The entire grid will be exported. Reports. You can export report data to a text file for import into other programs for formatting. You will be presented with a standard file save dialog box. Enter the name of the file to export to and click save. The entire report will be exported. Graphs. The export graph dialog opens when you select file, export from within a graph window. Select the graph you want to export. You can then choose to export it as a picture, either as BMP, JPEG, TIFF, or EMF, or export the data entered for the drug or combination, or export the curves plotted by the program. In each case, you will be presented with a standard file save dialog. Enter the file name and type, then select save. In summary, Calcusyn is considered to be one of the simplest and most commonly used software for quantifying synergism or antagonism.